Hi, this is Renee Romeo. Today we're going to make these individual bench cushions. I'm going to give you a supply list. I'll let you know what tools you need to accomplish this project. You'll see that we're installing a continuous zipper along the back so that we can take this off and wash it whenever we need to. We're basically assembling three separate boxes in order to cover these foam pieces with. And in order to get those done, we need to purchase some foam. And the foam that I've purchased is 3 inches thick. It's a green high density product. If you're out there looking for foam and you're seeing either blue or green, purchase that because that's best to give you the resilience you need when you sit on the bench. It's going to be nice and comfortable. If you see white foam, avoid that at all costs. You will not be happy with the results. And so just stick with the green or the blue. So in order to cut this foam, the only tool that you can use to do this with at home is an electric meat carver. It will give you a nice sharp edge all the way around and give you the perfect dimensions that you need. And in order to mark it, I've got a nice big T-square. It'll give us a nice square edge to this foam, and we can go ahead and use that along with a Sharpie marker. So the next thing is, on top of this foam, we're going to be putting some 1-inch thick polyester fiberfill sheeting. And what that's going to do, it's going to fill in all the gaps that you might have around your fabric and your foam and make it a really nice plush looking product. So let's talk a little bit about fabric. The fabric that I've chosen, it's a leather look. It's really beautiful, and what it has, it's a little bit unusual in that it has a fuzzy backing to it. So the fuzzy backing is again going to enhance that nice plush look that we want out of this comfortable cushion that we're going to be sitting on. So I have 4.5 yards of that in order to cover my entire project. It's also going to cover the cotton cording that I've purchased. I've purchased 21 yards of cotton cording. That'll go all the way around all three of these cushions, top and bottom. And we'll cover that with the fabric. So the next thing is I bought 4 yards of, this is a zipper, and it's zipper that's in one continuous length. And I can cut it at any point and make individual zippers out of it, which is what we're going to do here, so that we can take the foam out of the covering and throw it in the washer if we'd like. It's going in a kitchen area and it might get dirty, so I want that option. So I'm going to go ahead and put zippers on all of these. In order to complete this zipper, you need to also purchase slides and stops. And so they come in a little package like this. It's going to give you the stops at the ends and this individual slide, and we can go ahead and make our own zippers. So we'll need a nice heavy duty needle in order to get through. We're going to be doing some hand stitching when we're putting on our polyester fiberfill sheeting, and we need to hand stitch that on. And so I also have matching thread to the fabric, which is what you're going to need in the back where you'll see the zipper. It will have to match the fabric because you will see
so
it.
So I've had this cut at the fabric store. I've never had a person at the fabric store do a nice job cutting. So do yourself a favor. Get a little extra so that you can kind of square things off. You'll see mine, you know, diverges from a square.
So I'm going to start at the end that needs to have the most cut off. And I'm going to just run it nice and square all the way down that length. And you can just watch me get started with it. Is all cut out. Everything is nice and square. So at this point, I'm ready to start encasing this foam in the polyester fiberfill batting. So I have a little bit of it started, and it comes 48 inches wide. So it's wider than what I actually need for this particular piece of foam.
And what I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and line all of this up, and you'll see how I'm cutting it. I have it laid out on the table with the wider piece at the bottom, and then I folded it over and I've simply cut it straight to the edge all the way around. Now, as I cut this, I'm also making sure that this is in there nice and snug. I don't want any air pockets in between the foam and the polyester fiber fill because it'll start bunching underneath the fabric as people sit on it.
Now, you can see here, when I come to a corner, what I'm going to do, I'll pull it nice and tight, and then I'm going to go ahead and cut the polyester fiber fill to the corner. So you see I've kind of made this rectangular cut here, and when I go ahead and sew it, I'm going to pull this side up and then I'll pull this side up, and then I can go ahead and stitch that corner into place. Now from this side, this is the back side that I'm working on. What I've done, I just want to show you how this is actually trimmed out. So it's trimmed out all along the top edge and along this corner, and then I simply take it and I pull it nice and tight, and I'm making sure that I'm doing that so that when people sit on it, this polyester fiber fill doesn't bunch on underneath the fabric. We don't want that, so we just make sure it's pulled nice and tight all the way around. So I've cut out the corner, and what this is going to do, it's going to allow me to take the fiber fill and bring it up the side and then cut out this corner, as you can see, so that I can bring the back up and make sure that everything is nicely lined up all the way around. So all four corners are going to be cut out and everything is going to be nicely lined up. I'm going to go ahead and stitch this and show you what it looks like when it's done. This is just a demonstration of the technique that I use for hand stitching all of this polyester fiber fill in place, and it really is just a matter of going in and over and in and over until you get to the end, and then you can simply finish it off loop by loop. So you'll see it's been stitched in place all along this top edge, which actually is going to be the bottom by the time I get everything all situated. I'm getting ready to cut the fabric for the individual bench pieces. So what I do to begin doing that is to take my T-square and line it up along the finished edge from the factory and make sure that I have a nice square straight line across for my very start edge. So now that I have that done, I can take my dimensions of my individual bench cushions, and yours can be the different sizes or whatever, but the same rule applies. I'm going to take my dimensions and I'm going to add half an inch to each side, a half inch seam, then the finished piece, and another half inch seam, and it goes in both directions. So for instance, if I have a 30 inch wide cushion, I'm going to add half inch, then the 30 inches, and then another half inch for a total of a 31 inch cut piece. Now, most upholstery fabric is woven, and that woven fabric happens to not have a stretch if you stretch it in either this direction or this direction. But in my case, this fabric stretches really easily in both directions, which is very unusual. So what I'm going to do with this is I'm just going to add a quarter inch to each seam allowance so that if I have a 30 inch wide piece, it would now be 30 inches and one half for my cut dimension. So with that being said, I'm going to go ahead and lay out all of my individual pieces. I have three cushions. They have a top and a bottom. So I'm going to have six of those. And then I'm going to have a 3-inch band that goes all the way around the entire cushion. So I'm going to take that off of the end of the fabric all the way around. Ordinarily, I would say to you, if you're going to do well cording for this, which is that covered cotton cording, which is this right here, you would go ahead and you would have an extra like yard of fabric that you would buy so that you could lay it out on a 45 degree angle and get that nice give so that it can make all the turns around the entire edge of the cushion. In this case, because I have give, I can go ahead and put it anywhere. So I'm going to put it at the end of my fabric. Let's take a moment to talk about how we lay out all of our pattern pieces on our fabric. So in my case, I have 4.5 yards complete. It's 56 inches wide. And so what I do is I take the larger pieces, meaning the tops and the bottoms of both cushion covers, and I have 6 of them all together. So all 6 are going to be lined up along the selvage edge. Then the piece that forms that band in between the two sandwiches will go here. So I need 3 of those, and they're 1, 2, 3, and they're laid out along the selvage edge as well. From that point, we can move over to the next portion of it, which is all of our welt cording cover. And so this is probably about 2.5 inches wide each piece, and I have enough room for 8 to 10 of these, and that's going to run the rest of the entire length of the 4.5 yards. So I have all of that, and then what I have here are 6 individual pieces which are going to form the back side of each cushion, one on top of the zipper area and one on the bottom of the zipper area. So that's going to complete the entire circumference all the way around the cushion cover. So that's everything. I have a nice big chunk here left over. I can either make throw pillows for the bench, or I can leave it in case the bench cover gets ruined. I can swap it out with another fresh piece. So either way you go, you're gonna have some left over. I'm always a fan of having extra fabric just in case you make a cutting mistake, or again, if something gets
ruined. Cushion covers are cut out for the tops and bottoms of all the cushions. And so once I have that done, I can now determine that piece of fabric, the length of it that's going to be needed to go all the way around this and sandwich together. So what I know is that I have a cushion that's 3 inches thick. So I know that this needs to be 3 inches at least, but I also have to add on 1/2 inch seam allowance on one side and on the other. So that makes for a total of 4 inches. Depending on what thickness your foam is, you're going to make those adjustments in this piece of fabric that you're cutting now. So what I do from that point is I take my tape measure, I get out my piece of top fabric, and I measure in 2 inches from the end in the back. Because you're going to be having a separate piece in here that's going to have your zipper in it, we need to make sure that fabric kind of wraps around a little bit to hide the zipper. In case you see it from the side, you won't see the zipper at all. So we've got 2 inches here. We've got, in addition to that, you measure out front to back, and then you measure out side to side, front to back, and then another 2 inches in. So once you add up all of those lengths, that's the entire length of the strip that you need. I need 3, so I'm going to go ahead and cut those out and then start in on the zipper portion. This is a quick tutorial on how to cover cotton cording to make welt cording to go around your entire project. So I get the cotton cording, I lay it on top of the fabric. I simply flip it over, and the cotton cording can be any size, really. And all I'm really looking for here is 1/2 inch tail here that can be sewn into the project. So with this measuring tape, I can get the edge of it butted right up next to the cotton cording underneath and make sure that I've got 1/2 inch here. The 1/2 inch is going to make this a nice, neat project all the way around. And you're not going to have any issues with it looking uneven or anything. So butt that right up next to that nice and tight. Get out your Sharpie marker, mark that in place, and then open it up, and then we're just going to measure this distance. And this happens to be 1 3/4 inches. So at this point, I'm going to mark this entire fabric at 1 3/4 inch wide strips and mark it the entire length, and then I can go ahead and sew this in place. Now that the strips are all cut, we're going to go ahead and start joining these pieces of fabric together. We need to make one continuous long length so it's easy to move along with the project. And you'd think that what you do is just put right sides together and sew them together like this. But if you do something like that, it's going to create a lot of bulk when you go to sew over this. It'll make a large lump in the fabric, and that's not what you want. So really what you want to do here is, instead of putting them right sides together on top of one another like this, you'll start out with your fabric facing up, and you're going to flip this piece of fabric over right sides together and make this perpendicular. So what you're going to wind up doing then is making a line sewing from this corner to this corner at a 45 degree angle. When you open that up, it'll be just nice and perfect, and when you go to sew over it, you're not going to have one lump here and one lump on top of it. It'll be staggered, so it'll look much nicer in the finished product.
So the welt cording is all sewn together. And what I'm going to do at this point is just take this excess fabric and trim it very close to the stitching, about an eighth of an inch away. And you'll wind up with something that looks like that. And then I can go ahead and lay that cotton cording in there and flip it over, and it'll look just great. Getting ready to stitch the cotton cording in place. And so what I do is I lay it on the wrong side of the fabric. I lay it in about an inch away from the edge, and I simply flip it over the top, and I make sure that I line both of these pieces up along that edge on the right hand side. Now, I have a heavy duty machine. There's a little piece in here that has a little curve in it that follows the line of my welt cord. Some machines have specialized feet that you can put on them to accept this welt cord, but if you don't have that, go ahead and put in your zipper foot, because you can get very close to the edge of this cotton cording with your needle. So go ahead and do that. And I'm just going to lay this in underneath, line it up, and start stitching. I also have monofilament thread in my machine because this is a stretchier fabric. I'm going to go ahead and use that. It'll be more resilient to people sitting on it and things like that. So let's get started. So I drawn this on the board so we can get a better idea of what we're talking about for cutting out our fabric to go around our zipper along the back edge. If this represents the teeth of the zipper, in my case, it's a quarter inch top to bottom, so I need to make sure that that's going to be visible from the back. I'm not going to cover it up. And I need to cut out these two pieces of fabric. So my entire depth here is 3 inches. So if I take my 3 inches, I take out the quarter inch and divide it by two, I've got 1 3/8 top to bottom here and 1 3/8 top to bottom here. But I don't cut 1 3/8. I've got to add on an extra inch to those measurements and to take up the seam allowance top and bottom. There's a seam allowance that gets sewn to the cushion itself, and there's a seam allowance that gets sewn to the zipper. So each one of these will be cut out at 2 3/8, and you can make your own determination based on the thickness of your cushion as well. So I'd like to show you how to make a zipper from one continuous length of zipper. So I've gone ahead and I've purchased 4 yards to complete all 3 cushions along my bench. And so what I need is a tape measure to go ahead and measure that. And so what I'm going to do is I'll take the entire length or width of that bench cushion individually. In my case, it's 38 inches, and I'll go ahead and mark that. And then what I need to do is cut it at that spot. So I take my pair of scissors, my regular scissors, and I cut it into this heavy duty metal zipper. And then I'm going to simply fold it a little bit so that I can get my blade in between the tines and cut that out. So now that's cut and ready to go. So I take one end, I choose one end of the zipper, and I'm going to separate it a little bit, about an inch and a half down from the top. And I'll take my pair of scissors and I'm going to trim it really close to that metal track. So you'll see what I've done here. I've made just a little zipper track here with the little fabric piece trimmed off. And so what I'm going to do at this point is I'm going to take the slider that comes in this zipper kit. So the zipper kit includes two sliders and two stops for the ends. And on this slider, I don't know if you could see this, but there's a split in the middle on one side, and then if I flip it over to the other side, it's completely open. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that side with the split, and I'm going to slide the left-hand side on, making sure that I keep this little handle part facing up so that it will slide. If you move it either to either side, it'll stop on you. So make sure that you do that and just slide it right on. So that's on. Then what I'm going to do is on the right-hand side here, I'm going to trim it completely down to where this other piece was trimmed to, and just cut in between those metal tines. So now you have something that looks like this. So I've got the slider, I've got this metal track, and I've got these two pieces. And so I'm going to pull this apart even further, and then I'm going to take this right-hand side and I'm going to slip it in the right-hand side of the slider. Now, this takes a little bit of jimmying to get it in there. And you're just going to slide it up and in. And then take this, and you'll see now I've started it, but it's a little off kilter. So what I need to do from that point is go ahead and separate this all the way down. I've started prepping the zipper for the back panel. And what I've done here is I've simply taken the two strips of fabric that I cut for the entire backing of the cushion, and I've simply marked it half inch away from one edge on one side and one edge on the other. And then I've flipped it over and I've placed that fabric edge right at the edge of the metal track, and I've pinned it in place. And so I'm going to just continue this down the entire length of the fabric on both sides, and then I can take it over to my machine and I can stitch it very close to that metal track on either side. And so once that's done, it'll be ready to go and I can continue making the cushion. So here's a close-up of the zipper. I'm working on the right-hand side of the zipper. My slide is here, so I'm going to open this all the way to the bottom. And I'm going to take my fabric and have that flipped over half inch and line it up again with that metal track, the very right-hand side of that metal track. I have color-coordinated thread in my machine, and I also have a zipper foot in my machine. So I'm going to take this about an eighth of an inch away from the actual metal and start stitching. Now, when you get near to the bottom edge, what I do is I raise my zipper foot. I actually close the zipper itself again to get it out of the way, put my zipper foot back down, and then continue on through the end. I have the one side done. Continuing on to make the entire band that goes all the way around the cushion, the piece that gets sandwiched between the top and the bottom, I've completed the zipper, so the zipper is nice and secure. And so at the bottom here, where that stop is, that's the portion that we're going to be working on. And so we've already cut our long length that goes all the way around, and I'm just going to put right sides together at that stop end, pin it, and then put a half inch seam through here. Now, this is metal, and of course with metal you don't want to sew directly through the metal with your needle because you're going to break it, but we can finesse it a little bit, and watch how I do this. I'm going to start a regular seam, half inch. Underneath here is where I'm getting to the metal, so I'm just going to slow it down and I'm going to
manipulate this a little bit with my hand so that the needle can find the space in between those metal tines, and we can get a nice secure stitch seam all the way down. And you'll see when I open it, it's beautiful.
I have a pile of welt cording here, and I'm not going to clip it until I get to the very end of each and every individual piece that I need to apply it to. So if you recall, we've got our very starter piece, which has this lip at the top, and I'm going to simply take my top piece. I'm going to make sure that I start in the back of the project, because the back of the project is going to be a lot less noticeable when I join this piece together at the ends. So I go ahead and I pin that on, and I make sure that I have my nice half-inch seam allowance all the way along. Now when I start this, I'm going to start stitching down about 2 inches from this lip, because I need to overlap it when I get to the ends. So I'm going to go ahead and pin it
now
in place.
This is how I clip it into the corner. So I have my piece of welt cord. I lay it in here. My corner is right here. And I'm going to cut it at a 45 degree angle from the corner so that this is able to make that turn. And I clip it directly up to the stitching on the welt cord. And you'll see now that can split apart, and I can continue on in this direction with that half inch seam. Okay, so now that that's done, I can go ahead and if this is my cotton cording where it ends underneath here. So I'm going to take this cotton cording and clip it so that it meets up with that bottom cotton cording in the end. Now I can take this piece, I can clip it all the way down. And then I can slide this in, and I can clip this at a 45, and you'll kind of see where the existing seam is. So I'm going to slip this in like so. I'll just clip out this entire seam here, because it's always good to join pieces of fabric together at a 45 degree angle. It's going to turn out a lot nicer looking and lay a lot flatter. So, with that being done, I can now flip over this top piece about 1/8 of an inch, lay my bottom piece on the inside, if you could see that, and then flip this over the top. And I'll pull it nice and tight, top and bottom, and then I can continue on with the stitching of the welt cord.
All of the cotton welting is sewn into place. So now that that is done, we can go ahead and start working on that piece of fabric that runs all the way around the perimeter. This piece has been sewn with the zipper in, if you remember, and the way that I'm going to line this up, I'm just going to put right sides together again, and I'm going to take this piece that has the stitching right at the end of the zipper, and I'm going to locate that about 1.5 inches in from the corner. So you'll see where I've got this seam, it's just going to come in right here, and I'll pin it, and then I can go ahead and I can pin the other end in place where that needs to be. And you'll see it winds up being almost exactly lined up with the corner, which is just fine because we can go ahead and trim this to any length we need to in the end. Typically, patterns might tell you to sew this piece together as one continuous circle. I don't do that. I really like to do that right at the end so I make sure it's a nice tight fit. Sometimes things get pulled as you're going along with your stitching and things get misplaced. So I really wait until the end there, and I'll show you how to do that once I get down to the machine. Now I've ended my stitching directly at the corner. So what I've done here, I've got my two ends. This end needs to come over to the top, and this one needs to come underneath. And what you'll see is that part of this is going to have to be trimmed off after I get done stitching it. So I'm just going to turn over this corner piece about a half an inch and line it up. Make sure that everything is going to set perfectly along one side and pin it. And then the other side, that's nicely lined up along that edge. And so all I'm going to do at this point is put this underneath the machine and stitch it in place. Now I have to be careful when I stitch over the top of this metal zipper. So I'm going to finesse it a little bit. Stitch it up to that point. And then lift my presser foot and skip over to the other side and stitch that in place. And that's what I wind up getting in the end. So I have my zipper that's free to be opened and closed. Now this is the exact length that I need to complete that circumference around the corner. So I'll just keep the right sides together, go back and finish off that stitching. Now you'll see this is nicely stitched in place. I have the zipper already in here and it's nicely finished on both ends of the zipper, and it wraps around the corner just enough to hide it from seeing it from the face. So I have my bottom section cut out and done, and so I'm going to give you some tips on how to make sure that this winds up being perfectly centered on top of the bottom section of fabric. Sometimes when you're sewing, as you're feeding it through your machine, things get tugged or things get pushed. And so we want to eliminate that and make sure that everything is going to wind up nicely lined up when it's done and have a really professional finish. So in order to locate the corner that you need to line this up, I do all four corners first. I locate those first. I take the existing corner that's been stitched. I just fold it all the way down and find my corresponding corner on the other side. So I'll take my trusty Sharpie marker and I'll mark that. And I'll do that on all four corners. So let's do it on this one just to give you a secondary look. So here's my corner. I fold that and make sure that it's coming nice and straight up from the bottom. Take the Sharpie marker and mark it. So those are my corners. Now I take a pin and I take right sides together and I line the very tip of that corner up with the mark that I just made and I go ahead and pin it in place. And one last tip before I start stitching is I'm going to reach inside of my zipper and I'm going to go ahead and open that all the way for easy access. When I'm done, I can flip it right side out really easily. So it's all sewn together. The bottom, the middle piece, and the top are all done. I've opened up the zipper and I'm just simply going to take the foam and stuff it inside. It'll take some jimmying to get it in there, but once it's on the bench, it's going to be beautiful. All three cushions are finally finished. You'll see that they fit perfectly together here. They butt up next to one another. There aren't any gaps. I still can have access here to my under storage and be able to lift that out. And you'll see that when I pull this off, A really great tip is to take one of these shelf liners, they're a little bit rubbery, and put it underneath your cushion so that it doesn't slip. And this is especially handy if the ends of your bench are completely open. If you have a situation where you have a bow window or a bay window, you might not need to do that, but it's a really great tip. Go ahead and do it anyway. You can, at this point, be able to unzip the cushion, pop this cover in the washing machine, wash it, and then place it right back on. And it's just a really convenient way to do it rather than stitching everything all in without any access to take it off. So I hope you've enjoyed watching this video, and join me next time for another great project. This is Renee Romeo. Thank you.